This is the JJO Morning Show Podcast with Johnny and Dee. Listen, rate, subscribe.
It's time for the JJO Morning Show 640 Sex Fix. Talk dirty to me, please.
Sex Fix brought to you by Magna Babes. Looking to get Magna waved? Hit up magnababes at gmail.com.
The Michelle is here with questions. Hello, Michelle.
Hi, guys.
What's up?
Oh, my God.
So, about this queefing, you know, I'm asking for a friend, but she can't even get through yoga without busting some of those out.
PC2.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's like, it's a real thing, you know?
Where did that word come from, and are we even allowed to say it on the radio? Is that that's a medical? I hope that's.
We looked up the origin of queef, but
wasn't it?
It's a Scottish saying.
Yeah,
I believe,
for air or something. I can't remember.
Is that what it is?
Yeah, quiff.
I thought it was maybe just the way it sounds.
No,
or something like.
No, it's. It's like a quiff or something. But how did we get to queef?
Yeah, let's see.
I don't know.
We always get there, apparently, daily.
We do get there.
That's
so
the issue.
So your experience with yoga is the root of the problem?
I mean,
what's the problem?
All those positions, it just it like forces it out. I don't know. It's a thing. It just keeps happening.
So what? Okay, so this is more for you than me.
Yeah, it's a variant of Scottish and Northern English quiff.
A
puff of wind.
To quiff. To quack. To quack.
You
to queef.
Something new.
That's right.
To beef. Yes.
We are here to inform the public.
Did your mother ever...
you laugh at that.
Do moms ever have the queef talk with their daughters?
I don't think so.
No, not a fact.
No, I don't think that's not a talk.
No, something you just...
There's no downside for just, anybody else other than the queefer.
Okay, you just figure it out on your own. All right, like, oh, whoa, whoops.
Oh, man.
All right.
I've been
There's
queef...
There's no way to prepare someone for that.
I've been queef free since 2011, thank you.
Oh, my God, you lucky broad.
I'm in love with you.
Well, I'll give you the guy perspective. The guy perspective is it's just funny. It's cute. I don't know why it's
cute.
Yeah. Well, what? Well,
I'll
it's
take
just
cute.
I'll take cute.
Well, what's the what's the alternative? I mean, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, well, I'm sure for a guy, it's like if you're hearing a queef, it means you're
like,
getting
laid.
Yeah, totally.
Daddy's here.
Oh, God. For Christ's sake.
Daddy bottomed out.
Oh.
No, that's good. God. That's good. So you are asking what? What are you asking? How to not queef?
Yeah, do other people experience that consistency?
What do you think? Is that
in the queefing business?
It might be a case where some Kegels might be needed.
What was their yoga? What was the yoga part of it?
She might have just been really relaxed. And
right.
I used to know this stripper that could kind of queef on command.
Really?
Yeah.
On command.
Yeah.
Is that a thing as you get older?
Well, I think she had. She'd birthed. So, like, you know, like some people can, like.
She birthed at the strip club on stage?
She'd, like, fart on command and stuff. Like, I think she, like, sucked in air and could, like.
That's a skill I have yet to acquire.
She's probably on OnlyFans doing it now.
It's kind of cool.
I don't know how long she worked on that, but good for her.
Well, I don't know why it just isn't part of the cacophony of noises that you get when you have sex anyways.
Yeah.
It's just part of the circus.
It is.
It's another sound effect.
You
know what I'm saying?
That's why.
And Joe, we love sound effects.
That's why you play baby making music in the background.
Yeah, we love sound effects. Right. Yeah, I don't know why it's so. It must be I mean, you're so self-aware. You just. Is it hurting your performance or something?
Can she queef the Star Spangled Banner? No.
I feel like if I do it so much, I'm going to have to acquire that skill. So at least I can impress somebody with it. You know? Oh.
Well, it's like, here's a general rule in life. If you mess up or something is happening that you're aware of, that you're not happy with or you wish you could change, own it. Double down on it. That's how you do it. You learn that as you. That's the trick. It's not even a trick. You just learn it as you get older to take some ownership of your crap.
Okay.
It's fine.
Or queef.
It's fine.
Ownership of my crap or queef.
Yes.
Okay. So here we go. Queefing. Normal bodily function happens when air is pulled into the vaginal canal and then expelled. It can be caused by a lot of factors. Constipation can even cause it. Hormonal changes.
Oh, wow.
Pelvic organ prolapse. That's not a good one. Recent vaginal birth. See, there you go. The stripper I knew. Tight or weak pelvic floor muscles. That's where Kegels come into play.
There it is.
Position changes. Sexual activity. Daddy bottoming out. God, I almost gagged just saying that. Stretching or exercise. All of those things. And it says here avoiding certain workouts, blah, blah, blah.
You know,
blah,
maybe
blah.
We need to reposition queefing as if you don't queef, you're not really trying. You know what I'm saying? You need to remarket queefing.
It's like in Big Daddy when he was like, everybody's peeing their pants.
Yeah. You ain't cool unless you queef.
See? Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, my God. I want to hang out with you all the time. We would have the best time together.
Seriously.
Well, sounds like a date. Well,
I'm just gonna hang out and queef at everybody.
I don't know what else to say. I'm out of the loop here. It's you two have a great day, and I'll be over here. You guys have a good lunch date.
Oh no!
Do it at an outdoor cafe, just in case.
Yeah.
Just in case.
We're gonna get kicked out of Tipsy Cow, dude.
So you have stress. I'm trying to get to the bottom of your. I don't even know what the question is still. What's the question?
You know what? I feel like I feel much better now. We can let it go. I think we solved it. Yeah. Hang out with you guys.
I think it's... If you're asking about guys, I assume you're with a dude. Are you with dude?
Yes.
Okay, so... I think it's kind of hot, actually.
That's good.
Yeah! 100%! It's kind of cool. I mean, there's fluid and... rhythmic slapping and things. Oh. What? Something's got to give.
Oh, no.
Something's got to give.
And it is air.
It is air. Oh, yeah, yeah. No, I think it's pretty cool, man. It means there's somebody's putting the effort in. I don't know what to tell you. It just happens. It's all good, man.
I'll take that with me.
So, yeah, yes, I don't. Tell your friend not to be embarrassed. I mean, when's the last time you farted? When's the last time you farted during sex?
It's been a while because I try to avoid being gassy during sex. Yeah. It was that goddamn Kirkland friggin' Costco brand granola with the probiotic.
Probiotics before sex. Come on.
Yeah, for sure. And I shut it down. I was like, we are not having sex tonight.
Probiotics? No way.
It's like, I have the walking farts. There's no way anybody's scissoring this house tonight. Yeah,
that's cool.
She sees the Costco brand coming out. She's like putting on her flannel pajamas.
Wow.
Yeah. Nothing sexy happening here.
Nothing sexy here.
No.
You got it. You got it.
Mm. All right. All right. So it's just air. I mean, I don't know. Pretty normal stuff.
I feel like that's a great title. It's just air.
I mean, if you've never heard a queef, you've never had sex. I mean, what's the deal?
Yeah, I guess you haven't had
Yeah.
Yeah.
Passionate.
Or done yoga.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, if a guy guy loves you and cares for you, he'll be like, oh yeah, that's got a beat to it. I think you can snap my fingers to it.
I like that. I like the welcoming it with open arms.
Well, or just don't do whatever makes the queef. All right, well then you're fine.
Yeah.
All right. Thanks. All right. Nice chatting with you.
You too, guys.
Okay. Be good. All right. All right. I still don't know what the question was, but anyways, that's fun. That's cool. Yeah. That sounds familiar.
Coming down your smartphone. One podcast at a time. Listen, rate, and subscribe to the JJO Morning Show podcast.
Workman's Relief for whatever the job throws at you. Like THC products derived from legal hemp to help you relax after a long day or just chill over the weekend. No need to drive out of state to get your THC products. Order yours at workmansrelief.com.
Get up with Johnny and D. JJO.
Okay, so yesterday we talked about what was National Toilet Paper Day. And we talked about how America, we use the most toilet paper out of any country. And we attributed that because a lot of other countries use bidets. I'm going to need PC2 there, bud. Well, I have a viral video. It's trending. People's reaction as they use a bidet for the first time.
Oh.
I was like, how weird that this is happening now. Video of many men and women trying a bidet for the first time. Most don't know how to activate the water. What?
I bet it looks a lot like that face I made when I got my first prostate exam.
Yeah.
I was like, hey, is this going to work? Is your butt going?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Roll up.
Most don't know how to activate the water, and all are very surprised.
Yeah, you need a little robot going 3, 2.
Yeah.
And then go on 2.
Right.
Because
it just shoots right in there.
Right.
Here we go.
It seems like an unnecessary splashy car wash experience for your bum.
Is it an on button?
Crank up on it.
Just crank it?
Yeah.
Oh, man. Here we go. Wait.
Ow!
This is like a nice little shower without taking a shower.
The accuracy is pinpoint.
She really
I know
liked
you could
it.
Warm the water up, too. That's a nice little touch.
I feel like I need a towel to wipe, not even tissues, because everything's sopping wet. I like feel like I gave birth to like 18 water balloons.
What?
Probably not even that much water. I don't know. Is it? Does it pulse or does it just steady stream?
It depends on the bidet you're using. Right. I don't know. Like at the Sybaris. It's just a stream until you're done.
I mean, do you want to be, but the poo has to splash around. It's got to fly.
It does when you flush anyway.
No, that's not my point. I mean, when the water hits it, your poo, and then it kind of flies around a little bit.
I think you can do like an initial wipe to get it off.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
And then you use that to clean it up.
Okay.
You know?
Right, no poops, no whoops.
Check it in with you.
Yeah. Sure, everybody has a different, like bidets.
Get your angle.
MO.
Probably take some practice to find your angle and your setting, your number. It's like a sleep number, but for your butthole.
Exactly.
Put on 7. Ooh, that's nice stream.
Right. I like 7, and then I like it at a 38 degree angle. You know, like, what are you doing here?
Just hits it just right.
Mm-hmm.
37, 38, whatever it takes. If you have a back problem or you're elderly, it might be a helpful friend.
Yes, for sure. And I know elderly people have a little more of a problem getting cleaned down now.
Sure, you've been down there.
I was told I have a nice wiping technique.
Yeah, I remember.
More than
show
one
me,
occasion.
Show me with your hand.
Nice cupping.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
It's kind of like, it's a little version of shake and bake with Talladega Nights. Shake and then bake on the pull side. All right, I gotcha. Jesus Christ. I'm glad I came to work today.
Good.
Learning a lot.
Too much, maybe.
It's enough.
It's an overstimulation. You're going to need to go home and take a nap. All right. Two young boys were dropped off at the wrong bus stop on the way home for school.
Oh.
Because the driver said it was the end of the route.
that sounds like Ohio, right? Let me guess. Just a guess.
Here's Sheila with her 7 and 9-year-old talking about what happened.
It was the last bus stop of the route, and one of the first bus stops.
I was like very confused. I was like trying to tell him that you skipped our stop and like, can we go back to the school? He said, no, we cannot. You cannot do that.
My heart sank. The school was very apologetic. I have not heard from the supervisor of the transportation department. I have tried to reach out to her a couple of times, left messages.
Yeah.
That's Texas.
Texas.
Ooh. In the first week of school, at least two families have had issues with their child's bus driver. A three-year-old pre-K student was left on a bus, and the school did not know until the kid's parent called to notify them that, hey, my kid didn't make it home. And then in a separate incident, those two elementary kids were told to get off the wrong school bus stop. After the driver was like, I'm done.
Let's turn it into a math problem. How many kids were on the bus, do you know?
Let's say 24.
Okay, so two got stranded. So, she's got a 91% success rate of
dude,
getting
right?
every kid home.
That's what the lawyer's going to say.
That's exactly right. These are fine numbers. Fine numbers. Any county. I don't care. Jeez. Boy.
The worst is that a three-year-old pre-K student.
Yeah.
Left on the bus.
Yeah.
How does that happen?
I don't know, man.
Man, oh, man. It's hard to find bus drivers, though, so they're probably hiring anybody.
Yeah, I was going to say that. I didn't want to be rude, but you just wonder what the average IQ is of some of these people they yeah. need to get on a bus.
They're like, we just need someone sober.
Sobriety is
anyone sober?
Like the baseline, right.
You know?
You work up from sobriety.
Right. Are you sober
and have you
anybody?
Have you got a driver's license and are you sober? Well.
Right.
Just swing her big, Jim, and that's all you got to worry about.
For sure.
Yep, and you might want to take a lap down the end of the bus, see if anybody's back there sleeping. So bizarre. Mm-hmm. Man, it gets hot in Texas this time of year, too. Just leave some kids out in the middle of nowhere.
See ya. Good luck.
Both had some Boy Scout training. Gonna have to bivouac somewhere overnight out of the sun.
Yeah. Wow. Well, they're pretty cute, too. Someone goes steal them kids.
Well, yeah, there's that. Wonder if it was a neighborhood. Yeah, end of the road.
Yeah.
Sounds like a horror movie.
They're just in the middle of nowhere, standing at a bus stop.
The eyes have hills, the end of the route. I mean, they have this.
The hills have eyes.
You know?
The eyes have hills.
I mean, it's both kind of got the same horrific feel to the title.
They aren't showing me the bus stop. They're just showing stock footage of buses.
Oh, no. Well, that sounds like kind of a lawsuit waiting to happen.
Yeah.
I don't know. Would you sue if that was your...
No, I would have a hard time sending them on the bus, though. That would be hard. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Another boy riding the bus saw the interaction and told them that they could go home with him and his mom would help.
Cool.
So what would have happened otherwise?
Well, yeah, what time of the day was it? I mean,
it was the end of the school day, so 3 o'clock.
Yeah, how far out in the middle of nowhere were they?
You know what I mean? And what if they got to that house, right? And the mom was some weirdo that kept the kids and trafficked them somewhere.
You know, it's weird when you say end of the route because you think you just keep going
on a loop.
To the school, yeah. And so they'd end up back at school.
Right. But maybe he takes the bus home.
Well, I know, but that means you're at a dead end. You're turning back around. Why drop the kids off?
It's the end of the route, John.
That's when the murders happened. No, I mean, why dump the kids? What was the reason for dumping kids off just because you're at the end of the road?
I don't know. And then, so, like, did he miss...
That makes no sense.
He missed their stop?
Well, then get it on the other way back.
He's not going back. It's the end. We've reached the end of the route.
So there were no houses between the end of the route and the school. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah. Well, thank God that other kid was all like, hey...
Yeah.
Hitch it home with me, and my mom will help.
I'd like to see a map, because none of that makes sense to me.
And good thing that mom was not a weirdo.
Yeah. Crazy story.
Yeah.
More questions than answers, bitch.
Yeah. Well, it's just bizarre to me that you are a school bus driver and your job.
But, dude, how many?
Your one job.
How many times are our lives in the hands of rapists, killers, delusional, psychopathic, possessed morons every single day?
Right. And you're just like, everything's fine.
You can learn a lot listening to podcasts.
Did you know that the hottest chili pepper in the world is so hot it could kill you?
Or you can listen to this one.
Bears can smell your menstruation.
I can smell your menstruation.
The JJO Morning Show Podcast.
Workman's Relief for whatever the job throws at you. Like THC products derived from legal hemp. These are legit delicious. Free shipping with products over $75. Order yours at workmansrelief.com for whatever the job throws at you.
Johnny and D, nowhere but JJO.
A missing 9-year-old boy in Brooklyn was found when a news helicopter saw a kid who fit the description sitting on the family's rooftop. You would have thought they would have looked there, but...
How old was the kiddo?
9.
Oh, okay.
So here's CBS New York's Dan Rice talking about how he saw the boy from the chopper while he's reporting on the story about the boy. Weird.
So as my pilot Eric Ross and I were circling around the building, we came across a person sitting in a chair over here on the rooftop. We zoomed in with the camera. It appeared to be the child that fit the description of the missing child. Now our CBS New York News assignment desk, they called the police department. They sent officers from the 61st precinct up to the rooftop, and sure enough, they found the child sitting in the chair. They gave us a thumbs up as they went down with the child. We were able to reunite him with his family just a few stories below.
Reunited, and it feels so good.
Some good police work there, Lou.
Damn right. Right time, right place, yada yada.
The boy's missing it, and you're like, thank God he's right there. But wouldn't you have the whole building searched already?
Well, I don't know. The roof of the last... Would you say an apartment or a house?
It's an apartment building.
Ah, yeah.
He's up on the rooftop.
Well, this is what happened in Hangover. They left Deuter. They left him on the roof of the Bellagio. It's a whole plot of the movie.
Yeah.
But that's just the movies.
Very good, John.
Yay!
We're learning.
Yay!
Movies are not real life. It's been a long climb for us, but we're getting there.
I think a more exciting story is that stupid balloon boy kid that got launched. They thought he got launched into the balloon. Remember that guy?
Phoenix, yeah.
Yep.
The dad wanted the reality show.
Mm-hmm. We're going to pretend to launch a kid up in a balloon.
You know,
he wasn't in the balloon, was he? Or am I remembering that wrong?
No, he was in the
basement or whatever.
Was he in the basement?
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, everybody. God,
he said
like,
we were doing it for the show, and then the kid puked on TV.
Like
yeah,
scrambled jets and that didn't end well.
The dad was. I mean, okay, that was the start of influencer culture.
Kinda, boy. That's boy. You're close.
You know that dad wanted a reality TV show.
Yep. Like stupidity took over common sense and hard work. You know,
exploiting the kids.
Right.
Everything else.
So crazy. That's a good call, actually.
Yeah, buddy.
I'll give you that one.
Goddamn balloon boy. Son of a bitch.
I'm going to have to shoot it out of the sky before it crashes into a building. I'm going to have to get out of here.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Okay. Did you see the friggin' the Six Flags Mexico story?
By the way, did you ever see the... not to get off on a tangent here.
I guess we are.
You ever see the helicopter footage of 9/11 when they were up over top of the World Trade Centers? Did you ever see that footage?
And they fell, or?
They could have. I think they could have pulled some people off that rooftop. I really do. I mean, hey, I know I'm just an idiot on the radio, but didn't they lock the doors to the roof?
I don't remember.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I mean, that was just some harrowing footage, but I mean, it certainly looked like, and who knows? I mean, wind, smoke, yeah, I get it, but heat, I get it, but boy, it sure seemed like if they had the right helicopter, they could have pulled a lot of bodies off that roof.
Yeah, I mean, hindsight's 20/20, mm-hmm. right? Yeah. Obviously, mm-hmm. and it was pretty scary. Nobody knew what the hell was happening.
Mm-hmm. No, I understand. I'm not talking out my ass over here.
But. Some people knew what was happening, but
yeah.
obviously not our EMS Anyways. People.
What now?
And continue talking out your ass, or are we moving on?
No, the ass is shut.
Good.
For 2 minutes. A 2 minute ass timeout.
Okay, good. Footage from Six Flags Mexico going viral. After a bunch of people got stuck on a ride almost 250 feet up in the air in the middle of a huge storm. Now, you might be asking yourself. I know.
Where was this at?
Six Flags Mexico.
Oh, Six Flags Mexico.
You might be asking yourself why people would go to Six Flags in the middle of a huge storm.
Right.
I also asked that question. And you might be asking yourself, why would Six Flags send people 250 feet up in the air in the like middle of a storm as well?
You sound like a talking head song right now. I asked myself, how did I get here? What is this large automobile? So weird. Like I'm in a David Byrne reality sideshow.
It's because I slipped you some mushrooms earlier.
Oh, okay. Good. I'm enjoying it.
The ride is called Supergirl Skyflight or Skyscreamer at some of their other parks. You're in a swing that spins you in circles. A lot of other fairs have them too, but those don't go very high. The Six Flags version, it hits a max height of 242 feet.
Yeah.
They were at the very top of the ride when it froze up, and they were sitting up there at 250 effing feet.
And in rolls the storm.
Dangling
of the
for 10 minutes. And there happened to be a torrential downpour at the same time. Video shows the wind whipping while everyone white knuckles it. You can hear a bunch of bitches screaming.
Let's hear those bitches.
This time. I would like to hear the bitches, please.
Cue the bitches.
All right, this is from TMZ.
God, that's so high. Yeah.
Yeah, that's what you get.
Sounds like.
Are you having fun? You having a good time? What did I tell you about riding them rides? What did I tell you? It's what I thought.
Well yeah. Hey, that guy's dropping F-bombs, but you don't understand he's dropping F-bombs.
You know who does? La Movida.
La Movida knows. There's one guy going, hey, man. We go to amusement park and it's starting to shorter lines, man. What? I'm just trying to get.
You can't do the accent, bro.
Well, I did it. I mean, I'm trying to be genuine. I'm trying to just put you in the moment. I mean, don't yell at me. I'm a method actor, man. F you. No. 240 feet,
dude. No.
Not even on a non-Mexico roller coaster am I getting on that roller coaster.
No.
That is so high.
Yeah.
Too far. That wind whipping reminds me of footage you see of those guys on top of Mount Everest.
Yeah.
You know, with the winds just never stop. I mean, it's always a 60-knot wind up there, but on a good day.
Oh, my God, no.
That is so nasty. And what's the name of this? A screamer or what'd you call it? Didn't it have a weird name?
Supergirl Skyflight or Sky Screamer.
The Sky Screamer.
It's terrible.
Wow. Well, you know, a lot of people always bitch about roller coaster rides being too short. Although this wasn't a roller coaster, was it? No.
No, it was that swing ride.
Yeah, that's where they swing you around. Yeah. God, at that height. There's.
I'm getting sick to my stomach just thinking about it.
So much can go wrong. And unfixable at that height.
Right. You're just.
So you have to ask yourself when you see a ride like that, you're like, okay, what are the emergency rescue? What's the method? What's the plan? Show me the pamphlet of rescue. Show me the guide, the how to rescue people guide on paper. Lay that out for me.
Did you see in Mexico too that lady fell to her death from the Ferris wheel?
Mm-mm.
Yeah, that was a couple days ago. At a fun fair, not so fun now, is it?
How long were they up there?
10 minutes.
Wow.
Check your shorts, dude.
Yeah, so you got rain, electricity, thunder, you're in the air, you're wet. It's perfect.
Yeah.
My God, it's the perfect storm.
Adios mio.
It's the perfect storm.
Yeah.
What if this rain hits this lightning with all this steel and metal and it come crashing together?
Yeah.
My God, it's like the perfect storm. It's a great moment in that movie.
Again, you are relying on other people to do their jobs thoroughly
right.
in order for you to stay alive.
I want to see an evac plan 240 feet in the air on a swing. I don't think it exists. I don't think there's anything on paper for that.
I don't believe there is either.
Anyways. Yeah, it's like, I mean, I don't know. Being on a ski lift is pretty fun. Stuck on a ski lift, like you go to Tyrol. And it stops because somebody crashes, you know, at the bottom. They can't get on the chair, right? That's kind of fun to sit there and watch everybody ski. And usually get a little flask. Shh, secrets. Tyrol Basin secrets. So that's a good thing.
Yeah.
But 240 feet in the air, yeah, I'm all right.
The torrential downpour. Terrible.
No. No, I'm not getting on those things. I will not let my loved one get on those things.
Nope. Over it, dude.
Replay today the JJO Morning Show podcast.
Hey, everyone. It is Ryan Seacrest here. Ready to heat up your summer vacation? Get ready. Things are about to get sizzling at Chumba Casino. Your summer getting a whole lot hotter with a special daily login bonus waiting just for you. So sign up now for reels of fun and reels of prizes right here at Chumba Casino with yours truly. Join me at ChumbaCasino.com and dive into a summer of social casino fun.
Sponsored by Chumba Casino. No purchase necessary. VGW Group. Void where prohibited by law. 18 plus. Terms and conditions apply.
Get up with Johnny and D. JJO.
Hard work, work. Hard work, work.
Hard work. That's what they say.
Hard work, work.
Hard work. I earn my pay.
Hard work, work.
Hard work. Do it every day.
Hard work,
I get
work.
Up about 2:45.
Hard work, work.
Got to go and earn my pay.
Hard work, work.
Put my boots on and lace them up.
Hard work, work.
Got another day to work.
Hard work, work.
Hard work. That's what they say.
Hard work.
Working 9 to 5.
Oh.
Take this job and shove it. I ain't working here no more. A woman done left and took all the reason I was working for.
Okay, a new study looked at the hardest working states in America.
America.
To determine where Americans work the hardest, Wallet Hub compared the 50 states across 10 key indicators. They range from the average work week hours to the share of workers with multiple jobs to the average leisure time spent per day. Yada, yada, shmada, shmada. Do you want to take a guess at the hardest working state in all of America?
Man, I do. Boy, I sure do. Thank you for the opportunity to be here today. Guessing things is my strong suit.
Yeah, no, it's not.
What, I have 51 chances? Thanks, I appreciate it. 52? 53? It's got to be one in there. Hardest working state. I say, I got to go blue collar. I'm going to go flipping Michigan, dude.
Man, no, Michigan. Michigan really? Is number 48. Actually, I was shocked at how low on the list Michigan was.
Well, it must be robots making cars now. All right, I digress.
Yeah, the only two states that work less than Michigan are New York and West Virginia.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. So, weird. That's shocking. All right. Who's number five?
Okay. The South Dakota.
Oh, really?
Yeah. South Dakota, Wyoming, Nebraska, Alaska, and Nodak coming in at number one.
Nodak. Nobody home in Nodak. Seven people.
Nothing to do in Nodak.
Seven people working their ass off in Nodak. They never stop working. They build everything.
Roads. Literally nothing to do there.
Literally nothing to do. How, yeah. And what, I'm sorry. What was the criteria? I was screwing around over here. What was the criteria?
Oh, no way. You were screwing around?
I clearly missed out on some important information.
Mm-hmm.
What were the parameters?
From average work week hours to the number of workers with multiple jobs. Average leisure time spent per day.
That doesn't work. What was the number two criteria?
How many people have multiple jobs?
So you have multiple jobs. I assume that's on the high side of multiple jobs, and then you have leisure time?
So it's hardest working states. So how many hours a week do you work? How many people have multiple jobs? And how much leisure time do people
have? So you can have people, so you want a little bit of both. You want a lot of leisure time, and then you want, there's a fair amount of people working multiple jobs because they're not well off.
Right. So average work week, employment rate, share of households where no adults work, share of workers leaving vacation time unused, share of engaged workers, idle youth, average commute time, share of workers with multiple jobs, annual volunteer hours per resident, average leisure time spent per day.
So it makes a little more sense if I would have paid attention there.
That's okay, buddy.
Yeah.
We're used to it.
The lower, yes, the less populated makes sense.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Weird.
So,
all
right. Yeah.
Could you live in Wyoming?
Yeah.
I could in a heartbeat.
Without a doubt.
No idea.
I could live in the top five states.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
No sweat.
I actually go to Wyoming more than I go to the beach these days.
So.
Yeah, it's strange. Mm-hmm. Just endless, wonderful beauty. I love it. I can't get enough of it.
Anywhere, yeah. I don't know. I've been looking at all those places. But West Virginia's low. I've been looking at property in West Virginia. I've been looking at property in Arkansas.
We got to start a DJ commune for because we have no pension. Just a bunch of DJs sitting around drinking Pabst all day because we don't have a pension.
Yeah.
On your property.
I knew it would be on my property.
We're not going to have Kool-Aid. We're going to have Pabst. Everything's going to be fine.
I know. It will be fine, or so you think. Arkansas, number 29. That's another place I've been looking at.
You could be our cult leader. You can come out every day at noon, shake your taters, and give a little speech and go back to bed.
Oh, I'm going to be busy. If we got property, we'd be busy. 33, Wisconsin comes in at number 33.
Mm-hmm. This is strange. Yeah.
I thought we'd be higher.
Hardest working state. Mm-hmm. So it's like you got to work longer.
Yeah.
To make ends meet, but but that plays into being a hardworking state, clearly.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Interesting.
It is interesting when you start.
I just equated more people with harder working, with more things to do in a place than less people that have to work more and harder. I had that backwards.
Okay. Yeah.
I'm just saying the population of Wyoming is probably the population of Detroit. It just seems like there's more people doing more things in Detroit.
Right.
Not sure why I sound like Johnny Carson all of a sudden. Just Detroit.
I get what you're saying.
Yeah, you know.
Yeah, there's also probably, like, I get that there's less people in Wyoming. But there's also, like I think about those like canyon towns, like even like when you go through.
I'm just saying, less people working more hours and more jobs.
Yeah,
equates into harder working. It's a weird equation.
Right, totally. But what else are you gonna do? Like, you know what I mean? Like, you kind of. If there's only 20 people in the town that you live in,
right? Exactly.
You probably. There's,
it's a weird skew.
Yeah.
How they sandwich that together.
You probably work at the same place your mom worked at and mm-hmm. your grandma worked at. And you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, I'm assuming there's not a, and maybe I'm wrong. I'm assuming there's not a whole lot of room for mobility there, social mobility there. And maybe you don't want to. You probably like living in
that. That'd change the name of, yeah. Change the name of who's the old tough son of a bitch. That's what they ought to name the survey.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Who can tough it out?
Yeah.
And make a living. Because, you know, what kind of opportunity is in Wyoming? I mean, you know, there's not a ton of manufacturing in Wyoming.
Right.
Trust me. I've been there a million times.
You're working on the ranch.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Or oil or the coal pit out in the middle of Wyoming and Gillette.
Right. Or you're driving you and know? Working at a tourist attraction.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
They're not that many jobs, but they're tough as nails.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that makes sense. And you're working crap hours. Yeah. Jeez.
Who's the most salty, tough hombre in the West survey? That's what we ought to change the name to.
Yeah.
Who's busting ass survey?
Let's see. I wonder if there is. Which state has the toughest people?
And I don't even think there's that many people out at that coal pit in Gillette, are there? It looks very, I mean, I know they got the big shovels, but I sure never see that many people around out there when I go through.
This is just a voting thing. Most mm-hmm. people seem to think Alaska has the toughest people.
Mm-hmm.
I can see that.
I mean, they've got my respect. I mean, it's a pretty unforgiving regions to work in.
Right.
Overall.
Yeah.
For the jobs you get, for the opportunities that you have to you. They're pretty tough opportunities.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it makes sense.
Okay.
Man, we wouldn't last a week out there. We'd get crushed.
No.
Thought it was tougher.
We're pussies.
Thought I was tougher than this.
No, we're babies.
I see the light now. I'll stay here in the hollow and
let turn on the air conditioning.
Take a nap with my cat.
The JJO Morning Show Podcast with Johnny and Dee. Listen, rate, subscribe. Catch a new show every Monday through Friday, 6 till 10 a.m. on 94.1 JJO or streaming anywhere in the JJO app. Johnny and Dee. Nowhere but JJO.